What's up? Welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to use iMovie step-by-step beginner's iMovie tutorial. So if you're just starting, don't worry, I'm gonna show you how simple it is to use iMovie. I'm not a very technical person. I have a team that does a lot of technical things for me, but I still don't let it stop me to take action because if I wanna produce something and put something out and do it in a timely fashion, sometimes I just like to do it and take control myself, especially if it's not something super advanced. If you do, however, see things that are very advanced on my channel when it comes to editing, just know that's not me, okay? But I use iMovie. If you have a Mac, it's for free. That's what's great. So you don't paralyze yourself from taking action. So in a minute, I'm gonna jump into iMovie on my screen, share my screen, and show you step by step some of the cool things you could do. I'm gonna use iMovie to even edit this video, cut things together, you can add audio. And this way you can start to take action. Maybe you wanna grow a YouTube channel, put videos out there, share videos on your blog. And all you need is your phone. If you have a camera, you don't have to be, you know, some super advanced overthinking, paralyzing yourself from taking action. It's all in here. This is where it starts. Just take action, and as you get better with different softwares, you can get more advanced, learn new things, you know, become better, get better equipment, right? But in the beginning, just start taking action. That's the biggest thing. So we're gonna share the screen right now, jump into iMovie, show you some things. If you find this helpful or valuable, please share it, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you on my screen right now. Okay, so here we are, I'm sharing my screen. To open up iMovie and you'll get this screen, you just go to your applications on your Mac, you find the iMovie icon, you double click it, and it's gonna open to this. You should see a screen like this. If you don't, come up to File, once iMovie's opened, and just go over to Open Library, Open iMovie Library right there. You should see a screen like this. Obviously, you won't have videos in your library if you're new to this, but I have a lot of videos in here, and you could delete them as well as you go to save storage space, but there's a lot of videos in here because I make a lot of videos and I put them in here to edit quick. So what you wanna do next is, once you see the screen, is Create, New, and you wanna click Movie. Trailers, I don't even mess with trailers. I'm sure that's good too. If you have time to do that later on, that's fine, but we're looking to do movies here. So we click Movie, and it's gonna open up to a screen like this. Now you notice I'm on my Movie 29, that's the name of it for now. Nothing's in here, nothing's in here. And what I could do is, I got this video, actually this is the video clip that's gonna go before the video tutorial that I'm showing you right now. I could drag it in here, drag and drop it in here, which I do a lot. Or if you don't have it on your desktop, you have to find it. Maybe it's in your downloads. What you want to do is click Import Media. Find, you know, if you know where it is, go to there. So I know that it's on desktop. Here it is, IMG 8027. So I'm going to import the selected one that I have. So once your video is in here, the next thing you want to do is drag this video down to where we can edit it. Okay, and then also up here in iMovie, you'll see File, Edit, Mark, Modify, View, Window, Help. These are like the main things that you use. You really don't use much of this stuff. You'll see that everything is really used inside of here. And the next thing you'll notice too is it's kind of squished together, this video. So what I like to do is expand the video so I could see everything. So if there's something that I want to cut out, for an example, like in this beginning of me walking and sitting down, I want to cut that out. So the way we would cut that is I would just click right where I want to cut. Now you can use Command B or, and it will split it, or you can use right click, split clip. That was right click, split clip. And then I'll just take this, highlight it, and delete it, because I don't want that in the video. So it's very easy, again, and as you're listening to the audio, if there's a spot that you don't like, again, you would just put your cursor where you want it. I like to click and highlight over it, and then I would just right click and split clip. If, you know, I didn't want to do that, you can just go to Edit, Undo Split. Very simple to use to split things up, to lower the audio volume, because I'm speaking in this. All you have to do is, when you see those two double arrows going north and south, to adjust the volume, and you just pull it down. So you just pull it down, and then you see it's 6%, 10%, You know, you just don't want to see it go too much into the yellow. Otherwise, that means it's probably not going to sound too good. So I'll leave it right there. It seems to be good right there. And if you double click, it shows you what it is, 79%. So we'll leave it there. And then again, I would go through this clip and just look for things that I don't want. I pretty much usually leave everything. That's why it makes it also pretty simple. But if there was something where I had to delete it, you saw how I just split the clip, highlight over it, delete it. Very simple. Okay, so remember, the reason why I'm expanding this, and I'm expanding so you can see, I just want to really show you right here to the right next to settings, this little bar, because sometimes when you load the video and it will be scrunched like this, it's no good because we really want to see the WAV files and audio files, especially if we're talking. So I like to make it very long so that I can really listen and see, oh, that's where I said that I didn't want, or that's where I paused or stuttered, right? So that you can zoom in, we can, you know, right click wherever we put this cursor and split it, and then we can delete if we want, okay? So I just want to make that clear. The next thing we're going to go into is titles. And this is where, you know, up here, you see my media, audio, titles. You click on titles, and it's going to give you all these different options. And these options are so that you can put text over your video. So I do like this one, and you could place it wherever you want the text to pop up. So we'll say there, and then we just double click in here, highlight, and then we could start writing here. Is my video, you know? So then what this does is, and you could change the top one, of course, too. As we're playing the video,
I am going to show you how to use.
You see how the text comes in? Now, the only issue with these texts, depending on, you know, that's over my face, so I don't want that. So I would try to look for another title, maybe the one like this, because it's bottom at the bottom left corner, and they're static. You can't really move them, so that one would probably work a little better. I use these titles a lot, I do, but if I have custom fonts and I want to put it in a specific place, there's another way that you can actually create PNG text in Photoshop, if you know how to use that, save it to your desktop, and just drag it in. And I'll actually show you that really quick. Let me just show you this so you understand. Go to File, let's go to Import Media again, let's go to Desktop, and let's... Yeah, we'll import this. So this was made in Photoshop. We'll import this. So here it is, right? So I imported this. I'm going to drag it, and let's say I wanted this to pop up right there. Now, you see how like it went from my video, and it goes into this. I don't want that to happen. I want this to go over my video, right? I want it to lay over like how the text will. So the way you do that, don't worry, I'm going to show you. Just make sure that you clicked on the text that you brought in or the image. It could be an image as well. And instead of up here where it says cutaway, you want to choose the video overlay style and you want to put it picture in picture. Boom, you see how it does that? Now inside this little video where you see me, I can actually, when it's highlighted just like that with the four blue dots, I can move this around where I want it, right? So now I can do that, pretty cool. So now when I start talking, boom, James Cook comes in. And then you could add other you could add other text as well. So that's what titles do, and that's how you also can import an image or a logo. If you wanted to always have your logo, let's say up here in the right corner, you just need to get your logo in a PNG file, put it to your desktop, go to File, Import Media, import it, and then you want it picture in picture. So if you come up with problems of why the picture, it goes from video and then the picture takes over, it's because make sure you're picture in picture. Cool little trick to get your logo or an image inside your video. And you know, these simple things will really help you. And just to get started, you know, there's other things that you can do, but honestly, a lot of the advanced stuff you don't need right away. Like, I don't use super advanced stuff. I'm just looking to add value, put out content that I know about. And iMovie, this is the things, it's very easy and simple to use. Perfect for beginners. So now that you see that we can add titles, you could pick titles, you could add and import images. Titles are cool, you could add your text. Very simple, you just double click in here, add what text you want, place it where you want it in the video, you can drag this, put it wherever you want. Very simple. Next thing is audio. Let's say you wanted to add music. All you gotta do is click up here, audio. If you don't have audio in your iTunes, then it's not gonna be in here. You need to then download it to your MP3 to your desktop, and then you can just do the same thing. File, import media, find it on your desktop, drag it in, and then what you're gonna do is drag it from up here to where you want it. Do you want the music to start here? Same thing too. As long as I'm highlighted on my video, so whatever I do is gonna edit the video. As long as I'm clicked and highlighted on the audio, now right here, if I wanted to split, again, right click, split clip, boom. If I didn't wanna do that, that was a mistake, it's not in the right spot, just go up to edit, undo split. You notice I really don't use much of the other stuff up here, file, edit, mark, for anything else. Everything's really done in here. Very simple, very easy. So that's how you add audio if you want it. I don't want this audio in here, so I'm going to just highlight it and delete it. So the next thing we could do is up here you see transitions. So transitions, they go between splits in the inside your video. So let's say we have a split here. Again, I clicked. I put the cursor where I want it. I'm going to right click and split clip. That's how I like to do it. You could also just put the cursor where you want and use Command B, and that will cut it also, split it. Now, transitions are these cool little effects that we can use between the video clips. So let's say you had one, like step one, right? And then now this was gonna be step two, so maybe you wanna use a spin effect in between. So it'd be like, all right, step one's done.
Step by step.
Boom, and then it comes into step two. You see how I did that little effect? So the transitions are cool. I use those as well, but I don't want that there, so I'm just gonna delete that. But that's how you use transitions. There's a whole bunch of different types. You could go through these. You know, they got cool little effects. You just go over them, and it'll show you how it will do. Slide from left to right, slide up. Puzzle. So pretty cool. You could use those transitions between your clips. Definitely, you know, mess around. And then there's also backgrounds. I like to use like these basic backgrounds. Let's say I wanted to have something that is just words in the beginning. So maybe I'd start with this and just, I could write welcome. And how would I write welcome? Well, after I pick my background, they have some basic ones, right? And they have like stuff like this, little designs, whatever is in here is stock. You just, whatever one you like, you pull, you drag down, you'd go back to titles where the text is. Now I just highlight this one, drag it over, double click in there, and write, welcome to my video. Very easy, pretty cool. You could also adjust the font. Maybe I want to use this one, you know, a whole bunch of different fonts. Really, really simple, easy. I hope this is adding a lot of value to how to use iMovie for you. Even if you're a beginner, this is what it's for. It's very simple. Don't overthink things. Just start taking action. Open up iMovie, put a video in, and just start playing with it. You're going to get really good, really quick at this in no time. So that's how you would add a background if you just wanted something with words. And again, you could also add these between clips if you wanted to put something that just says words. Cool little thing. Another thing we can do is we can actually do a voiceover. So the way we would do that, let's say I didn't like how something sounded in my video in the beginning, or I was like, oh, I wanted to say something, or maybe I wanted to say something here. Maybe I want to say, welcome to my video when that comes up. And I forgot to do that. I wanted to put that in the beginning. What I would do is I would come over here to the mic. See this mic? You click this mic, put the cursor where you want it to start. So if I wanted it to start right here when this is coming in, I'd click right there. I'd come over. Now I know, see this where the cursor is, where this line is where I'm gonna start my recording. I'm gonna click record. It's gonna go 3, 2, 1. Welcome to my video. Stop. So now you see my voiceover went right over here. I could adjust the volume. Remember, on any audio, you just see those double arrows, adjust volume. Now I could slide it down. Slide it up to where I want it. And now I have that welcome to my video lined up because I did a voiceover. Very simple, very easy, comes in handy. You'll notice that if you start using iMovie a lot and you needed to add some audio of you saying something. I don't want that there, so I'm gonna delete that. And whenever you wanna delete something, you just click it, delete it. So I think you get the big gist of exactly how you could use iMovie. Let me add one more image in there so that you get that clear as well. So again, let's say we wanted to add, I showed you if we wanted to add more text or a logo, and that text could be any type of text. It could say, you know, welcome to my video, whatever you want it to say. Let me show you how to add an image. Same exact thing. Let's say you have an image on your desktop. You could either drag it from your desktop into here, which I like to do, and I'll show you. So there's an image right here. I'm going to drag this image. See, I just dragged an image of myself here. There I am. I could also put this, if I wanted it to be in the beginning, and I could put text over it. Again, if I wanted to add text, you know, just drag the titles down. So I don't want that image in there, so I'm gonna delete that. That was just from a video. But you see, you could drag images in, add them where you want, add text, just split the clip. Another thing you could do that makes it easy, let's say that you split the clip. Maybe you like are saying something and you don't like how it sounds right here. All you have to do is when you see these double arrows where the split is, you could drag it back. And you see how I'm going back over? And that's why it's so important to have this really, really, really expanded so you could see exactly where you say things. So you could try to really get your split clip right where you need it, but you could always go in here and maneuver, and you just hold down on the left side of the mouse and you're just dragging it over. So I encourage you to play with that as well. Little cool trick. And the last but not least thing is, once this is ready to go and your video is done and you watched it and you're good with it, all you have to do is, I like to come up here, right here in the right corner where you see that download button, click, and you could click file, name your video what you want, tag it, what the resolution should be, and then you would click next, and I would save this right to my desktop. That's how you do, and then a little clock will pop up here as it's downloading to your desktop, and once it's complete, you'll get an alert that your iMovie is complete downloaded, and then you can just take it right from your desktop, put it wherever you want, embed it somewhere, put it on YouTube. So that's exactly how you do it. You could also click file and then also share, and you could share it anywhere, or you could just click file again and do the same thing, get it to your desktop. But you could put it on YouTube if you want, Facebook. I suggest getting it to your desktop first and then uploading it. That's just how I do things, but again, everything's here, email. So that's how you use iMovie. If you're a beginner, you could just stop, rewind, watch this. Hope it's very helpful. Please subscribe to my channel. Share this video with anyone that you think this would be helpful for that's trying to make videos and get out of being stuck. See you on the next video.